It's time to put the black in black metal. Swedish Wolves Wattain have amassed a notorious reputation in the genre of extreme metal, be it their theatrics, which they do live, you know, pyrotechnics, or the rather controversial blood episode. But then again, if you put all this aside, this band has produced some really fine black metal throughout their careers, be it the critically acclaimed Swoon to the Dark or the Swedish Grammy award-winning Lawless Darkness. This band has never shied away from experimenting and doing what they deem fit. The band comprises of guitarist and frontman Erik Danielsson, Pelle Forsberg on lead guitar, and Håkan Jonsson on drums. We take a look at the sixth studio album, Trident Wolf Eclipse. Coming down to the artwork itself has been done in signature Wattain style and signature black metal style. I mean, look at it. They've got their symbolic trident that has been there on all of their work throughout the timeline, either subtly or evidently, in this case, rather evidently. And they've got this almost ritualistic scenery and background going on with the mountains and, you know, the sun, the trident in the sun. Safe to say it is pretty cult. Things don't start off, they blast off with the first song. And the first song in this album is Nuclear Alchemy. This, of course, has been released to YouTube, and if you go through it and you look at the atmosphere and the aura that has been created, pretty much is the atmosphere and aura that is setting the tone for this album. Of course, you know, like most black metal songs, it is fast, it's frantic, they've got the guttural vocals, but where Wattain changes things up is they introduce this atmospheric element. This, of course, gives some amount of layering to the song, because in Nuclear Alchemy you can hear it in a very explosive fashion, and then again this has been used in different ways throughout the album, sometimes as transition effects and sometimes in the back is done in a very archaic old school black metal style, and it's safe to say it's a hair-raising experience. Fans of the genre will love the blast beats and tremolo. The riffs are also quite catchy. You know, it sort of pitches in and out of melody, and that's what Wattain has going on different. There is a certain pattern to it, and it is present in most of the songs among all that carnage. At the same time, they maintain the furiosity and intensity. Fellsrike takes the pace down a notch, but then it increases on the heavy element. This song is an example where, you know, the guitar itself is working as both, of course, the distortion monster, which it is. And apart from this, they are also able to use maybe the patch or the tone in a very elemental aspect. Check it out. Not to mention Eric's vocals are massive. I like the fact that when you cut through the layers, you're able to hear that melody. It's a clear melody. You know, they're using the riff itself, the pattern of the riff in itself might not be a melody, but when you put it together, you're able to hear it, especially from the third quarter of the song. The song, of course, comes to a screeching halt with all the squealing harmonics. This again, where I mentioned they're using it for transition effects. So you've got this muddy distortion and squealing harmonic, you know, that's sort of leaving you in this oblivious place. You don't know where you are, what to expect next. And then the next song takes off. What's to like in this song? I ask you, what's not to like in this song? Heavy riff, massive drumming, it takes a lot of twists and turns, plenty of solo work, and again, this song leaves you in this muddy, distortion, oblivious world. And it's very picturesque. Not only enjoying the song, you're having an experience. You know, if you close your eyes, So the patterns are different. Like, if you gave two bits of the pattern someone and just made them hear it randomly, you might think they're of different songs or they don't relate to one another. But what Wattain does on this album and does really well is that they're able to take very different sounding elements or riffs and put them together seamlessly. The second half of the album moves to a more gothic side of things, Again, it's not all goth. You still got the black metal stuff, but you've got some amount of this gothic atmospheric effect going on, like in songs like A Throne Below. I mean, the track uses the guitar like a horn. How do you even do that? You also got some tracks which end in this manic laughter. Gives me the goosebumps. There is some amount of bass guitar soloing which is prominently heard in the breakdown of Toward the Sanctuary. The album comes to a close with some massive firepower using all those elemental effects, you know, those manic, eerie effects along with this heavy distortion and, you know, creates a really ominous atmosphere. So what do I like about this album? Let's start with the good bits. Of course, we mentioned that Watain as a band is able to engineer various kind of riffs, you know, that may not necessarily be related, but they engineer it in the overall song structure to make it sound seamless. That is absolute pure genius. And apart from this, I like the atmospheric effects. I think they go really well with the black metal element. It's not overpowering, neither is it too far in the background. They use it differently in different songs, sometimes as transition bits, sometimes as the main bit, sometimes as the chorus. But it is used in a way that it justifies the song that it is on. I also like the production. Of course, black metal music is a little raw on production. This album too is raw with just enough polishing to be able to squeeze in all the additional orchestration. When asked why it took them 5 years to release a new album, the band did give out an interview saying that, you know, they wanted the previous one to run its course and then they wanted to get into the creative aspect. And I agree with this, because if you're writing music and you're just out of the creative process of one and you get into the other, first point, you may just end up continuing a creative process and not necessarily writing something new. That is evident on this album because it sounds fresh, it sounds completely different, and it's got its own character. It summarizes what this band is about and, you know, who they are and what their music is. The use of melody and atmospheric elements keep pitching in and out enough to keep the user engaged. While at the same time, it will satisfy fans of the genre who like it, you know, old school. While Watain has strayed from the general formula, they aren't necessarily reinventing the wheel here. It's not something we haven't heard before. It is another black metal album. What it is, however, is a proper black metal album. And it stays true to the band's vision. It creates a world while you're listening to it. Trident Wolf Eclipse creates a picturesque realm of the underworld while staying true to the band's vision and delivering a great black metal experience. We give it a 7 on 10. For a more in-depth analysis of the album and a track-by-track discussion, be sure to check out our WordPress site. We've got a link in the description. What do you think about this review? Have you heard the album yet? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, stay metal.
We are Decided. Watch Deep TV. Stay metal.
Stay metal.
Oh my god, this is much better than what you thought.